Welcome to Divine Art of Food. In this video, we'll see the recipe of street style parota. For that, in a bowl, take 250 grams of maida, 1 teaspoon of salt or salt according to your taste, and then add 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon. Now mix this well. After that, add 1 tablespoon of oil into the flour. Now add 1 cup of water or water needed according to the consistency of the dough you want. Give this all a nice mix and form it as a ball. Knead the dough well. Before that, apply some oil over your table in which you're working with, so it will prevent the dough from sticking onto the table. Now, kneading is the very important process in parota making. Punch the dough as I am doing and just hit the dough onto the table so that the kneading is done properly. After that, give the dough a nice ball-like shape and place it into the bowl by applying some oil onto your bowl. Now apply some oil over the dough also. Now place a towel over the dough and rest this for 1 hour. After 1 hour, remove the cloth and you can see how soft the dough has become. Now take it out of the bowl and knead it once again before you roll it. Now divide the dough into small balls so that you could roll it off and make parotas out of it. Now roll the dough very thin as possible by flipping it off. Don't leave any foldings in the dough, so make it straight and then roll it once again by applying some oil so that it will be easy for you to roll. After rolling it, just make some flips out of the parotas like this I'm showing in the video and take it off and give it a small roll. Roll it over your palm and tuck the remaining portion at the back side, and you could see the several layers of the parotas in the side. Now just press it with your fingers itself and give it a perfect round shape and see how the layers have formed well. Now it is time to cook. Now on the tawa I have placed my parotas. Now you must cook this for about 7 minutes to 8 minutes on each side. Now add 1 tablespoon of oil while you're cooking the parotas. Now our parotta is done. Transfer it to a plate. And you can serve this yummy parotta with plain kurma, which is from my video. You could watch that recipe. I have given the link in description of empty kurma. And you can also serve with some mint chutney and raita, which tastes absolutely divine. See the outer crispy layer of parotta, how it has come out well, and it is only due to a perfect rolling of parotta. The best way to eat parotta is that just divide it into small pieces and pour your empty kurma or salla and enjoy this dish. Please give this recipe a try. You will surely like it and enjoy this recipe with your family. Each bite is full of flavors. I'll see you all in my next recipe. Bye.